Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you're new. My name is Katariina. I'm really excited about today's video because I will be continuing decluttering today. So today we are going to go through all of my face products. But before getting into the actual declutter, I just wanted to give you like an overall look at my face product collection. So these are all of the face makeup products that I do own. This golden container is on top of my vanity, actually. And I store here products that I do want to stand. I also do have there my lip care products, so those are not something we are going to be talking about today. But here I do store my foundations and my setting sprays. Then I do have a one drawer vanity, which I'm really happy to have. It was my goal during my Nobuy year to get my collection into one drawer vanity. And the white baskets are in my vanity drawer. In this basket I do have some complexion products that I am using at the moment. And on the basket on the back, I do have some backups and things that don't match me at the moment. And then the last basket over here is all of my powders and all of my cheek products. And then over here I do have a couple of face palettes. And in the magnetic Tarte palette I do have some depotted highlighters. So yeah, this is what my collection is looking like right now. It's not even close where it was a couple of years ago, but still I would like to have less. I would like my makeup collection to take less space. And even though I am able to store all of this either in my vanity drawer or this little container on top of my vanity, I would still like to have a collection that looks kind of like more clean and not this cluttered. Now I will say, what comes to complexion products, I'm not probably going to declutter a lot, because those categories like primers, foundations, concealers, I have been able to get down to my kind of like ideal numbers with project panning, and I'm really really happy about that. But maybe there are some things that I need to let go of. That being said, what comes to cheek products, I think I would like to downsize my collection a little bit, so we'll see how I do there. But yeah, I just wanted to give you an overall look at where we are right now, so that we can compare once we are ready and I have cleaned all of these little baskets. A couple of more things that I wanted to mention before we actually get to talk about the products. First, when talking about face makeup, I think it is important to acknowledge my skin type. So I do have a combination skin, and my skin is pretty normal otherwise, but I do have a really really oily T-zone. And during summertime, during the warmest months, my skin tends to be more oily all around my face, but it's never really super dry. And another thing I wanted to mention quickly is that once we go with this declutter, I will also be talking about my goals, where I would love my makeup collection to be. In general, my goal would be to have sort of like a minimalist makeup collection. So with those things out of the way, let's just get into the primers. So I do have at the moment 5 primers in my collection. And I will say it is more what I would like to have. That being said, 2 of my 5 primers are almost gone. So I do have the First Aid Beauty Hello Fab Coconut Skin Smoothie Priming Moisturizer. I absolutely do love this primer. This is the only hydrating primer that I have really ever liked. Because I do have a combination skin, I don't like anything that is too heavy. But on the other hand, I do like to prep my skin with a hydrating primer, especially if I'm going for a matte foundation. So this one is just the best. Another favorite is the Urban Decay Optical Illusion Complexion Primer. So this one is a pore filling primer. As you can see, mine is almost gone. But I really, really do enjoy this primer. And I also absolutely love this packaging. It is an airless pump bottle, so it will stay good for longer. And also I love this pump because with this one I'm able to actually control how much product I get, and I don't get too much, because with a primer like this, a really small amount goes a long way. Now I also do have the e.l.f. Poreless Body Primer. And I will say that I do like this product. What comes to the actual formula, I don't think it's too different from the Optical Illusion Primer from Urban Decay. I actually think they're really similar. I have only used this for a couple of times though. But I just really don't like this packaging. Like, I don't know what I was thinking when I bought this. I knew already that I loved this primer, so I don't know why I wanted to try another pore filling primer. I'm going to use this up for sure after I have finished my Urban Decay primer. That being said, in future I think I do want to stick to the Urban Decay one. Okay, then I do have two mattifying primers. So the e.l.f. Matte Putty Primer, this one I have not yet tried, so I'm willing to give go to it. I do have this Becca Ever Matte Poreless Priming Perfector, and I absolutely do hate this product. I was ranting about this primer in my theme project pan update because I rolled this in and I tried this on. This one makes my foundation look worse than it would without a primer. However, I wanted to give this another go with a foundation that has more like satin finish, a little bit of glow, because I thought that might be a little bit more forgiving with this primer, but no, this one still looks horrible under my foundation. When I put foundation on top of it, my foundation skips. So sadly, I am going to declutter this product. It's just not worth it to me to force myself to finish a product that actually ruins my entire makeup look. So yeah, I'm not going to use this, and I wouldn't recommend this product. If you're going to do some last minute Becca shopping, I would for sure recommend you to stay far away from this primer. Okay, and these are the primers that I'm going to keep. So I'm keeping four, but one is almost gone. But ideally, I would like to have from 2 to 3 primers. A hydrating primer and a pore filling primer are staples that I always want to have. But possibly I would love to find a primer for summer that makes my makeup last longer and perhaps helps with oils. I'm going to give a go to the e.l.f. Matte Putty Primer, but we'll see if it actually helps. I'm also interested in trying one of those gripping sort of primers. For example, CoverFX has a primer like that, so maybe that would help makeup stay on longer when it is really hot. Let me know if you have tried the CoverFX Gripping Primer or another primer similar to that. I would really love to know your experience. Okay, let's get to one of my favorite makeup categories, and I think this is my favorite complexion category at least, so foundation. I do love foundation because nothing makes me feel better than a good foundation. So I do have 6 foundations at the moment. So yeah, this is a little bit more what I would like to have, but let's just go through this. So I thought we could go in order from most natural to least natural. So first is my NYX Bare With Me Tinted Skin Well. So this is like a tinted moisturizer sort of product. Now, I know tinted moisturizers and like a really natural no makeup makeup look is really popular nowadays, but it's just not really my kind of look. That being said, this is a beautiful product. It really evens out my skin tone, and it's kind of like my skin but better. Like my skin looks like skin but more even. That being said, I never reach for it. Even on days when I want to go for a little bit more natural look, I still tend to wear more natural foundation. Even if I want to go a makeup minimalist, at least at this point I don't want to change my makeup routine to be like a no makeup makeup routine, because I just don't feel that is me. So because of that, I did roll this product into my theme project pan. I'm trying to use it up because I do enjoy it. I think it looks beautiful on the skin. But I don't think it is a staple in my collection. Next is the Catrice HD Liquid Radiance Foundation. This one is really too deep for me. So maybe I will show you how deep and orange it is. It's not something I can wear on its own. Except if I do have a really, really good tan. And that really doesn't happen here in Finland. And anyways, I have been thinking about not really trying to get tanned anymore. I mean, obviously when the summer comes, I will be outside a little bit, but I'm not going to be laying on the sun. So I'm just going to declutter this. I just don't think I will be getting so tanned this becoming summer that I would actually need foundation this dark. Plus, this one is a really, really glowy foundation, and in summer, it is not necessarily the most flattering finish to me. It has anyways been open for a little bit longer, what it says in the bottle, and I'm trying not to have products what comes to primers and foundations that are too much past the expiration date, because I have reacted previously because of using expired foundation, and it's just not worth it. Okay, so next is my Catrice True Skin Hydrating Foundation, and this one is not going anywhere. I have been raving about this foundation recently. It's my new favorite. This is a medium buildable coverage foundation that has a satin finish to it, and it just looks really amazing on skin when I first apply it and also throughout the entire day, and it also feels really comfortable and hydrating. I do have the Nabla Close Up Futuristic Foundation. I think it is okay. I wouldn't say there's anything wrong with this foundation, but I just don't think it's anything that special that I would buy it again, because this one still costs about 3 times more than my Catrice foundations, and you know, this isn't really any better than my Catrice foundations. So this is a foundation that I did roll into my team project pan, so I'm going to use it up, but then I'm just going to stick to my Catrice foundations. And my holy grail matte foundation is the Catrice HD Liquid Coverage Foundation. I do have 2 bottles, so my winter shade, light beige, and then I do have the same sand beige, which is from last summer, so this is in my summer shade, so I will need to make sure to get it used up this becoming summer. But I absolutely do love this Catrice HD Liquid Coverage Foundation, because even though it's really, really full coverage, it is still lightweight. I do want to get the Nabla Foundation and the NYX Foundation, or the NYX Tinted Skin Well, used up. And after that, I would only have my Holy Grail foundations. Now, ideally, I would like to have only 2 foundations. So, a more natural everyday foundation, which is the True Skin, and then a matte full coverage foundation, which is the HD Liquid Coverage one. That being said, for me, oftentimes it is not realistic to go through my summer foundation during one summer. So, because of that, I usually have one hanging in my backup drawer, but that is okay, but in future I will only stick to these foundations. Okay, then let's talk about concealer really quickly. I'm not going to declutter any of these because I do like all of these. So I do have 4 concealers. I do have the Urban Decay Stay Naked Correcting Concealer. I do really enjoy this concealer. This one has really good coverage, but not as full as something like Shape Tape. But I really do like this because this one is not drying on my under eyes at all, and it keeps looking nice on my under eyes throughout the entire day. I wouldn't say it is as hydrating as the e.l.f. one, but it looks nice. Then I do have 3 of the e.l.f. Hydrating Camel Concealers that I absolutely do love. However, sadly, this concealer is not really well available in Europe, so I'm probably not going to be purchasing this in future unless it becomes available on European retailers that sell e.l.f., so for example Lux Plus or Feel Unique. I think ideally I would like to have 1 or 2 concealers open at once, so 1 good under-eye concealer. I do still think that I would like to have a highlighting concealer. That is something I don't really have at the moment. However, I can use this Urban Decay one to highlight if I want to. But to that, I have liked the Revolution Conceal and Define Concealer because it is really, really lightweight and it doesn't really cover that well. Okay, so next is powders. 3 of them are kind of like starting to be gone soon. But this one is the Revolution Lace Baking Powder. I don't have anything left in this container. I'm just going to keep it as long as I have the product, but I have moved it to this Lily Lolo container that is almost empty. Now, I have already bought a backup for the Revolution powder, so this one is from a brand Paese. I don't know if it's supposed to be pronounced like that, probably not. But this is a Polish brand and this is their Puff Cloud under eye powder. So I decided to give this a go. But if I don't love this powder, I'm just probably going to set my under eyes with whatever powder I use to set my face. Because I don't know if it's really that necessary to have a separate setting powder for under eye. But yeah, I do have two under eye setting powders. One of them is just almost gone. Then I do have two face setting powders. Now, usually I do prefer a loose powder, but I do have pressed powders now. I do have the Milani Prep Set Glow Illuminating Transparent Powder. I do absolutely love this powder, but I'm wondering if I should try another glowy setting powder, because Milani products, they tend to be a little bit more here in Europe. This powder is often sold at almost 20 euros. For a little bit over 20 euros, I would be able to order the Bare Minerals Illuminating Mineral Veil from Feel Unique, and that is something I'm curious of. But this is a great illuminating setting powder if you want to find one like that. That is a budget-friendly option. Then the mattifying setting powder I have right now is the Catrice All Matte Plus powder. This one I am not planning on repurchasing. But I'm going to run out of this soon-ish, and then I will try to find like a holy grail mattifying loose setting powder. Then I do have my The Balm Sexy Mama powder. This is what I use to touch up my face when I get oily. So yeah, these are the five powders I have at the moment. So if we take the Revolution powder away, that is almost gone. There's four that I kind of feel are staples in my collection, except I'm not exactly sure if I really do need a separate under eye setting powder. At least I do not want to have more options than this, because here I do really have everything that I need. I'm going to keep all of my powders for now, and three of them are almost gone anyways. Okay, then here are all of my setting sprays. So I do have four. I'm going to keep all of these four. I do have three from Urban Decay, and I absolutely do love Urban Decay. This one is almost gone. So it is the all-nighter one, and I do have a backup ready to go. And then I do have the chill one, which is my favorite hydrating setting spray. Now, I do have one setting spray from the store that I work in. I talked about in my The Theme Project Pan update why I haven't bought really beauty products from the brand or from the company that I work for. So if you want to hear more about that, check out my The Theme Project Pan update. But last holiday season I slipped when this setting spray went on sale, and this was limited edition anyway, so you couldn't buy it. But this product I'm panning now in my The Theme Project Pan. But I'm using this one as my hydrating setting spray until it's gone, and after that I'm just going to stick to the Urban Decay ones that I love so, so much. Okay, so let's move on to cheek products, and let's first go through my bronzers and contouring products. You know what, I'm going to declutter the cream contour stick. I do feel a little bit guilty about this, because this one is newer to my collection. I bought this on Black Friday. I used to have some cream products, including this one, in my collection back in the days in 2016, 2017, and I also had some cream blushes. However, I decluttered all of my cream face products because I'm just a powder face product girl. But cream products have been really popular recently, so I wanted to give cream face products another go. And unfortunately, I gave them another go just to realize again that I don't really enjoy cream products on myself. I do think they can look really beautiful and really natural. That being said, I feel they are more effort to apply. Like, I do think it's just so much quicker to bronze my face with powder than try to use a cream. And also, I don't necessarily enjoy the like sticky sort of feeling that a cream face product can leave, unless you set it with a powder. But then I don't have a powder that I could set my cream face products with that doesn't change the color. Another thing with this NYX Wonder Stick that is really annoying is that the highlight side broke, so the entire thing came off. So now it is just like really, really annoying to use. And also, I feel the contouring side, it's just not really the ideal color to me. It's little bit too cool and ashy sort of color. It's just not the most flattering, so I'm just going to declutter my cream face products. I don't enjoy them, and I feel a little bit bad that I bought some of them last year because I totally fell into the hype of cream products. However, the rest of my bronzers I'm going to keep. So the Balm Bahama Mama I absolutely do love. This one is really old, so I'm trying to use it up right now. I have repressed it and there is not much left, so I'm sure I can finish it this coming summer. This is my perfect contouring shade. Maybe I should swatch my bronzers to you. We are going to be here forever. So yeah, there you can see the Bahama Mama. Another matte bronzer that I have is the e.l.f. Primer Infused Bronzer in the shade Forever Sun Kissed. I don't really love this, but I do like this enough to finish it. It is a little bit lighter than the Bahama Mama, and it's, I don't know, it's kind of like neutral, but it sort of has like a yellow tone to it. Then I do have a couple more shimmery bronzers. So the Too Faced Sweetheart Bronzer in the shade Sweet Tea. They don't really have more shades to this bronzer than this, but this one is actually a gorgeous bronzer. I don't really like the packaging, it's really bulky, so not a fan of that, but the bronzer itself is amazing. This is a really gorgeous shimmery neutral bronzer. Absolutely do love it. In color it is pretty similar to Bahama Mama, but it has the most beautiful glow to it. And this is like my favorite summertime bronzer, when I do have a little bit of tan and I want my skin to look like really glowy and sun-kissed. And then I do have one bronzer from Essence. So this is the Essence Luminous Matte Bronzing Powder. It is over there, you cannot really see it that well when I swatch it, but when I apply it to my face, it totally shows. However, this is a really, really light and a really, really warm bronzer. And a bronzer this light would only show up on me when I am my palest. That being said, this one is quite warm and I don't think it really goes with more cool toned makeup looks, at least, or with pink looks. I would just prefer a bronzer that is a little bit more neutral than this. So because of that, it's not necessarily a staple. I absolutely love how it looks on the skin, but I just feel the makeup look that I have on should be a little bit more on the warm side to pull off this bronzer. So I'm going to keep this for a bronzer for now, but ideally I think 3 would be what I would be happy with. So the Bahama Mama as my matte bronzer, the Too Faced Sweet Pea bronzer for my shimmery shimmer bronzer, and then something really, really similar to the Fusion's Formula Butter bronzer. And if it just seems like I'm not able to find anything else than that exact bronzer, maybe that is what I will go with. In general, I'm not a fan of the brand, but, you know, I need to think about if I'm going to purchase that bronzer again or not once I have finished these two. Okay, so we have the two most exciting categories left in this video, I think. So, blushes and highlighters. And I really do want to downsize my collection a little bit from where it is right now with these two categories, because I feel what comes to blushes and highlighters, they are one of the slowest going products. And I just don't want to have products in these categories that I don't use in my collection. So at the moment I do have two blush palettes in my collection, one of them being a cream blush palette with 4 blushes, one of them being a powder blush palette with 4 blushes, and then I do have 8 single powder blushes. So if we count all of these together, I do have 16 blushes, which is not nearly as bad as it was one day, but this one still feels more what I really should have, and I don't really use all of these blushes. So, as I already said when I was talking about the NYX Wonder Stick, I do want to declutter all of my cream face products, so I'm going to declutter this. This is the e.l.f. Cream Blush Palette in the light version. It is a nice formula and everything, but I just don't like cream face products, and I should have learned my lesson with this years ago, but no. Last year I bought the cream contour stick from NYX and then this palette from e.l.f. Okay, so after that we do have 12 pans of powder plus left. And you know what I think I'm going to do. I can't believe I'm doing it, but I just need to do it. I'm going to declutter my BH Cosmetics Vanilla Cream Truffle Blush Palette. Now, I really do think this is a great blush palette, and the formula is amazing, but I just don't like face palettes. Plus, I don't really reach for these colors. This is the most neutral one of these palettes that BH Cosmetics has, but it's still slightly colorful to me because I am the most boring neutral blush wearer ever, and I don't really use something that is more on the bright side. Now, they do describe this being nude and mauve tones, but for me, these are more like a pink, a berry, and a couple of corally, neutrally sort of shades. I think this one down here I have maybe worn once, this one maybe a couple of times. Berry I don't wear ever, it is too dark for me. And the color that I have worn most out of this palette is this one. However, now that I have repurchased my Hourglass Mood Exposure blush, I can never see myself reaching for this one over the Hourglass one, because they do kind of like the same thing, although the Hourglass one is more neutral than this. This is like a light, cool pink. So I am going to declutter this palette. So here you can see the swatches. I mean, they are pretty, but I will say I don't think they are really truly like neutral and mauve tones. Like, I think the two warmer ones are clearly more on the coral side, and then this one is clearly more pink, and this one is clearly more berry. So yeah, they are just not necessarily my ideal blush colors, and the format of a blush palette is not my ideal format. Alright, so I have now already cut my blush collection down to half since I decluttered my blush palettes. And if I'm being completely honest, I'm probably not going to declutter any of my powder blushes unless I will declutter this. This is the Essence Matte Touch blush in the shade Rose Me Up, and this one is really, really old. I think I have bought this in 2017. I do like this blush, but I wonder if it is too similar to the 100% pure blush. Oftentimes when I'm going for like a matte, really neutral blush, I'm kind of like torn between those two, like which one I would wear. So I want to swatch these blushes side by side and then decide if I'm going to keep both of them or only the 100% pure one. Okay, so here you can see them swatched. I actually do think they look different enough for me to keep both of them. I think the Essence one doesn't have as much pink in it. It is like truly a beige blush, and that is actually something I really enjoy when I'm going for a cooler toned neutral look. So for example, a taupe look. This one looks amazing with a look like that. The rest of my blushes I am going to keep because I really do love all of them. So I do have the e.l.f. Baked Blush in Rich Rose, which is my oldest blush. I was able to hit a little baby pan on it recently, if the camera just picks it up. So as you can see there, a little black pan sewing. This is a beautiful glowy rosy neutral blush. Then I do have the Essence Satin Touch blush in the shade Satin Love, which is kind of like my pink blush because I don't typically like too pink blush, but this one is kind of like a neutral pink. I oftentimes hear people when they talk about their blush collection saying that this is their most neutral blush, and I'm like, oh, it's one of my most colorful blushes actually, because I think it leans so much pink. So yeah, when most of my blushes are like bronze and brown. So I would say that this one and the Milani Luminoso here, that is like a peachy blush, they are my two most colorful blushes now. So yeah, that's kind of funny. Then I do have the Essence The Blush in the shade Beast Bow, which is like a truly bronzy blush. And then I do have here, so this is the Benegos Natural Fresh Bronzing Duo. So there is a blush and a bronzer, but I just use the entire thing as a blush. And it is like this beautiful matte kind of like terracotta color. And then of course my Hourglass Ambient Lighting Blush in Mood Exposure. I have used up one of these previously and I just had to repurchase because there's no color more perfect than this to any kind of like cooler toned mauvey look. So yeah, I absolutely do love that blush. Other colors and in fact other products from Hourglass I'm not really interested in, but that one is just so special. Okay, so here you can see my current blush collection swatched. So again, the Essence Matte Touch blush in Rose Me Up, which is like a true matte beige. The 100% pure Pretty Naked blush, which is like a matte little bit pinky leaning nude. Then this is the Elf Baked Blush in Rich Rose, and it is just a gorgeous neutral rosy blush, and it's really really glowy. Another glowy one is the Essence, the blush in Bespoke, which is like a true bronze. But what I love about in this is that it's not too orange, because I feel for a lighter skin it can be hard to find a bronzy blush that doesn't pull too orange, and this is just perfect. Then this is the Benegos Bronzing Duo, which is one of my favorite blushes for fall and winter. Then this is the Milani Luminoso, so my perfect peachy blush. Then this is the Essence Satin Touch Blush in Satin Love, which is my kind of pinky blush. And then the Hourglass Mood Exposure, which is like the most perfect mauvey nude blush ever. So I'm so happy with my blush collection. I don't really know what to say. I am on a blush no buy right now. There's not a single color of blush that I would really want to add into my collection. So I think with blushes, I'm kind of like on a replacements only sort of thing, where if I finish a Holy Grail favorite, I can replace it with a similar thing, because I do think that for the most part these are staples that I would replace with similar thing. Even maybe the Essence Matte Touch Blush, because I would always want to have a blush in my collection that is just like pure beige. So I actually think the 8 blushes that I have right now is my goal. I don't need to have more, but I feel if I'm starting to take away some of these blushes, I'm starting to lack with some of my kind of like Holy Grail basic shades that I would actually wear. Okay, so last but not least is highlighters. Thankfully, I don't have any highlighter palettes in my collection anymore. I used to have some of them in the past, but they were the same thing than blush palettes that they just got overlooked. I do have, however, some depotted highlighters, and I do have 3 highlighters here from Ofra that are from a highlighter palette. Then I do have a couple of other depotted highlighters, so in my magnetic palette I do have 5 highlighters. Then I do have 4 powder highlighters, and then I do have 1 liquid highlighter that I got from my The Pip Box Advent Calendar. And this one I'm going to declutter. You probably can guess it that since I don't like cream face products, I also don't like liquid face products. That being said, liquid highlighter is something that I have been able to use it in the past as body makeup, but if I'm being completely honest, I can highlight my collarbones and my shoulders also just with my powder highlighter. I don't need to have a separate product to that purpose, and this is something I would never put to my face, so I will rather have someone else to have this. Yeah, now that that is out of the way, I do have 9 pressed powder highlighters. I don't know where to start. Let's start with this highlighter over here. It is depotted from a Vicar Icon highlighter palette. Vicar Icon is kind of like a house brand of a store called Sokos here in Finland. I really do love this highlighter color. It is this cooler toned, light champagne-y sort of highlighter, but it's not white, but also it's not pink, so it's almost like a champagne with sort of taupey undertones to it. So over here it is. I hope you can see. Absolutely do love this, and once I have finished that highlighter, I'm going to replace it with something similar. The thing is just that these kind of highlighters are really really difficult to find. Then another highlighter here that I have depotted from a palette is this one that is almost gone too. It is depotted from the BH Cosmetics Carly Bubble Deluxe Edition palette. So this one is a beautiful, beautiful warm pink. I feel I'm really picky with pink highlighters, because a lot of the times they pull just like really cool and frosty, and I don't like that. So here it is, I hope you can see. But I do have another pink highlighter. This one is from a brand Inmo, I think it is. It is their Moonlight highlighter. I got this one from my The Pip Box last year, and this one is another pink. I don't like the color of this quite as much as the BH Cosmetics one, but I think this will do. This one is also warmer, but it's not as warm, and this is a little bit lighter, so it is a little bit more of that frosty sort of finish. But I feel at least I should give this highlighter a go before decluttering it. We'll see when I have finished the BH Cosmetics highlighter and when I have tried this, if I actually end up loving this or not. Okay, then one highlighter that also pulls a little bit pink is this one from Ofra. It is the Ofra highlighter in Blissful. This one I actually think is like a rose gold. It's not truly pink, but it's kind of like this gold that pulls pink. Here you can see it. It is a gorgeous, gorgeous color, and I love the Ofra formula. That being said, this one is a little bit dark for me. It just doesn't work for me unless I do have a decent tan. And as I have told already, I try to avoid getting a really good tan in future. And I'm not into self-tanning either. So what comes to cheek products, I don't necessarily like to keep something that really doesn't work for me if I don't have any tan. And I don't really ever wear this Ofra highlighter, so I think it's time to let go of this. Okay, so those were all of the kind of like cooler toned and pink pulling highlighters. Then I do have one like truly peachy highlighter. This one is from Revolution. It is the Revolution Pro Lustre Highlighter in the shade Pink Rose. But even if it says Pink Rose, it is like a true peach. And it is a gorgeous packaging. Oh my gosh, it looks so pretty, but what matters is the actual product. Now, I will say this color is really pretty. It is like a true peach. And I feel, I'm sorry, I'm all the times out of the picture. I feel a true peach highlighter can be a little bit difficult to find, because oftentimes I feel highlighters, they either pull pink or then they pull gold. This one is just a true peach and I'm going to keep it for sure. Then I do have the Essence Pure Nude Highlighter in this Be My Highlight. I absolutely do love this highlighter. This is the most gorgeous, your skin just glowing from within sort of warm highlighter. It is kind of like a peachy, champagne sort of color, but it is really, really subtle. So let me show it to you. There you can see it. I hope it looks a little bit darker than my skin, because it is, but I feel I can still make it work. However, it looks best if I do have a little bit of tan, so in summer and in fall, but I can also make it work right now. So I'm going to keep it even if the tone is not the most ideal. But I would like to have another really, really subtle highlighter that is in a lighter and more neutral color. So one that I have been thinking about is the Catrice highlighter in Light Infusion, I think it is. So maybe that could be kind of like my winter version of this. But I don't think I'm going to purchase that or any other highlighter before I have finished this bigger icon highlighter. But yeah, if you know a little bit lighter, a little bit more neutral, or it could even lean slightly cool highlighter that is just really, really subtle, let me know down in the comments. That is something that I am on a market for. And then I do have three kind of like more golden toned highlighters. So the lightest one of them is the Ofra Star Island highlighter. And this is just like a really, really light yellow gold. And I'm going to declutter this. There you can see it. It's just so pale that I think it's too much for me. And I have had highlighters in similar colors previously. I have decluttered every single color like this except this, because I thought that this is the best formula and I still think it is. But even having only this one in my collection, I don't wear this. The only occasion when I would wear this highlighter is if I want to wear the Rodeo Drive shade, which is that one over there. But if I feel I want to brighten it a little bit, so then I will layer it with this. But I just don't wear this on its own. It is too pale for me. So yeah, this one is going. Okay, then next is the Balm Mary Luminizer. I really do love Mary Lou. I have used up one of these in the past completely. And you know what? I'm not far from hitting pan on this one either, because I have been focusing my like inner corner highlight brush onto that one spot, so I'm sure I will be able to hit pan on this one also soon enough. So here you can see it is just my most perfect golden toned highlighter ever for my complexion. It is like the perfect depth. It's not too light, but it's not too dark. Unlike this one, unfortunately, is maybe a little bit too dark for me when I don't have any tan. Don't get me wrong, I'm going to keep this and I'm going to probably put it into a project pan later this year in the summer. So this one is the Ofra Rodeo Drive. It is the most beautiful like golden highlighter. It literally looks like Hollywood gold. So here you can see it. It's so reflective that it almost looks lighter than Mary Lou, but it is actually a little bit deeper, and if I don't have any tan, it's just not the most ideal for me. And I do think what comes to golden toned highlighters, Mary Lou is really everything I need. So my goal will be to pan to Rodeo Drive. So yeah, these are the highlighters I'm going to be keeping. So I'm going to keep 7 highlighters for now. That being said, 3 of these I do want to finish this year. But what comes to the 3 that I'm going to finish, I want to find a replacement for one of them. And I would love to find one that is like really, really blinding. And I would also love to find like a little bit more cool tone or neutral and lighter, super subtle highlighter like this one. So that would mean that my highlighter number would be 6. Now, if I'm being completely honest, who really needs 6 highlighters? Nobody. But I feel for those 6, you know, I would have a place in my collection because they would be different enough. And I feel with those 6 highlighters, I would have really every color that I need. Yeah, I will set my highlighter goal to be 6 for now. Maybe in future I will realize that I don't need that many, but at the same time I don't feel 6 is out of control by any means if all of the highlighters are different enough. Okay, so here is still a quick look into the things that I decided to declutter. I don't think it was a huge declutter. I mean, this is not a huge amount of product. However, my goal with my declutters is not to have as big declutter as possible. It is to get my collection to be so that I enjoy it more. And I totally think I did achieve that. And I am really proud of my declutter, especially what comes to the blushes. I got my blush collection down to half, so I decluttered both of my blush palettes. Okay, and here is still a quick look into the products that I decided to keep and my collection right now. So what comes to the size of my collection, I don't know if it is that much smaller. I mean, I do still have all of the containers that I used to have before doing this, but I do think that visually it looks more pleasing right now. There is not quite that much clutter going on. I will say to here, I will add the lip care products, but these are all of the products I will have standing on top of my vanity. Then this one goes in my makeup bag. One change that I made is that I moved my face powders to my complexion product basket, so I'm really happy with that. And anyways, there's not too many products in here right now. Then here are all of the backups. And what comes to these 2 baskets, there are a bunch of products that are almost gone. And I have already backup here, so once I finish the product that is open at right now. So for example, the Revolution Lace Powder that is in here. Once I finish that, there will be less clutter here too. Then I'm really happy that right now in my cheek product basket I only have cheek products, so highlighters and blushes and bronzers. Then I do still have 3 depotted highlighters in this palette, but eventually I would want to finish them, hopefully this year, so that I would have this palette only for my eyeshadows, and then I would only want to have my cheek products in here. But yeah, that is the result of this declutter. It was a super long video, so thank you if you watched it all the way through. See you on my next video. Bye bye.